All right, what's up, everybody? Hope you guys are doing well. And today we're going to be talking about nursing pay in 2021 and my argument as to why that nursing pay should increase significantly in 2021. But I don't see that happening right now. But first, I want to talk about inflation. I'm going to talk about rising prices. There's a difference between rising prices and inflation. I'm going to get into that here in just a second. But first, let me introduce myself. My name is Crosby Steen, former ER nurse, former nursing professor, former travel nurse, and now nursing entrepreneur with my own successful nursing practice. If you're interested in anything like that, hit the follow button, hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, hit the dislike button, hit all of them. Anyways, let's get started. All right, so first, guys, we're going to talk about inflation. We're going to be talking about how this is going to correlate with nursing, the rise in nursing pay, why I think it should be going up significantly, especially right now with what's going on in the job market right now. Right now, there are plenty of jobs for people, but nobody wants to fill them up. And this is because of the government printing so much money, the extra money in the system, which is causing inflation. But first, let's talk about inflation. What is inflation, right? So a lot of people think inflation just means the prices are rising up. But really, what inflation is, by definition, is inflation is the expansion of the money supply. So when the government just prints all this money, right? It's not back to anything. It's not back to gold. It's not back to silver. There's nothing that is really back to. They can expand the dollar. And this goes into modern monetary theory versus Austrian economic theory. And there's lots of differences there. I'm not going to get too far into that, but I do want to talk about what that means for nursing pay going in 2021, because if we're going to see inflation because of the expansion in the money supply causing prices to go up, right? We're also going to be devaluing the dollar. So every hour that you work as a nurse, right? That dollar, what that dollar buys a lot less now because of the expansion of the money supply. So now, since your dollar is worth less, your hourly pay needs to go up. You see what I'm saying? Because you're doing more work for less money because of inflation. And over the past year, you know, we've seen this expansion in the money supply from not just stimulus checks, but from unemployment benefits. We've seen an expansion of the money supply from just money printing alone, from quantitative easing. And, you know, the other thing is we're putting a higher workload on the nurses. Would anybody disagree with me when I say that over the past year, 2020, that nurses were extremely, extremely taxed? They were working extremely, extremely hard. And in some cases, we did see great prices for travel nurses. You know, we saw a lot of great benefits. However, what a lot of people seem to understand is a lot of these travel nurse assignments, where you're seeing like 7,000 a week type assignments, you're also working 60 hours a week. So there's not that much of a difference. But what I'm really kind of talking about here is why you guys need to start demanding as nurses. You need to start demanding your pay go up. You need to start negotiating your pay to go up. And I've talked about this with independent nurses, and this seems to be a ongoing thing. You know, when you go to negotiate your bill rate as an independent nurse, you know, you need to keep all of this in mind. Look, with there's so much money in the supply right now, the more you work, the more hours you work, and the less that dollar buys, guess what? You're actually getting a lot less than you should be. So nursing pay needs to increase with the rise, with inflation and the rise of prices across the country. You know, if you want to buy a new house right now, good luck. Good luck buying a new house right now for a decent price, because the market is really, really tight right now. And as long as the Feds keep the rates down, that's going to continue to happen. You know, if the Feds decide to raise rates, then we may see a slight dip in housing prices. But that doesn't look like it's going to happen for the next few months. Along with inflation going on, we have a big problem here. Now, the Fed thinks that this inflation is actually temporary, which they call transitory inflation. I don't necessarily think so. I think inflation is here to stay. You can't put the toothpaste back in the tube. I mean, once you're steady paying prices, you know, you're paying certain prices for lumber, or you're paying certain prices for meat or milk or whatever it is, do you think those companies are going to come down on the prices? I don't think so. I think inflation's here to stay. Until we get it under wraps, we're going to have a big time problem. All this money printing and spending by the new bills coming out by the Biden administration is also going to hurt this, because we're going to continue to see that expansion in the money supply. And as long as we see that expansion in the money supply, we're going to see prices rise. And especially if the Fed is not going to be raising rates to counteract that. So anyways, I want you guys to think about this. If you're a nurse, think about your pay. Think about you working harder, but your dollar buying a lot less, right? So if your dollar buys a lot less, then what's the point of working more, but you're actually getting less for your dollar? You see how that's sort of a tax, how inflation is a tax in and of itself? You know, if you think about it like this, if your dollar doesn't buy what it used to buy, right, then you're getting taxed at the grocery store because you're paying more for steak. You're paying more for milk. And let's don't even talk about the gas prices right now. So nurses, you guys need to start demanding that you get raises in pay. None of this, I know nurses right now that are out of college getting paid $19 an hour. Now, I don't know about you guys, but $19 an hour for as hard as you work to get through nursing school and to bust your ass for 12 hours on a shift to only get paid $19 an hour and to deal with what you deal with, that's not acceptable. Every nurse at a minimum should get paid $30 an hour. That's at a minimum, a new nurse. Across the board. Now, I don't know what the nursing unions say about this. I don't look at all that. I don't pay attention to any of that because those are different kinds of politics involved. But I do want, especially independent nurses, if you're an independent nurse, you really need to pay attention to this, because if you were getting a bill rate of $80 an hour, you now need to get a bill rate of $90 an hour so your dollar will buy the same as what it used to buy. So I want you guys to think about that. What should the nursing pay be in 2021, I don't think any nurse, me personally, should get less than $30 an hour. No RN should get paid less than $30 an hour. And it's happening across a lot of places, but that's just me. And especially if you're a travel nurse, you need to be getting a lot more for what you're putting up with. And especially if you're an independent nurse. So just some things to think about, guys. So I know this is gonna be a quick Sunday video, but this is something that was on my mind. I wanna hear what you guys think. Let me know in the comments below, what do you think the pay rate should be for nurses going forward in 2021 and beyond, especially deal with inflation. So, all right. Anyways, guys, that's it for today. Peace out.